गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट कीनबॉक्स डिजीज। कीनबॉक्स डिजीज इज अ रेयर डिजीज बट इट इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ पेन इन द रिस्ट जॉइंट। सो इफ दिस इज योर रिस्ट जॉइंट, इफ यू आर हैविंग अ कीनबॉक्स डिजीज, यू विल बी हैविंग पेन ऑन दिस एस्पेक्ट, मोर ऑन द डॉर्सल एस्पेक्ट। यू हैव पेन, यू हैव ओकेजनल स्वेलिंग एंड यू विल बी हैविंग डिफिकल्टी इन मेकिंग दिस मूवमेंट। सो द डॉर्सिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द रिस्ट, इफ यू आर डूइंग दिस, दिस विल बी पेनफुल and you will be have tenderness on the palpation. So if you are touching here, then this portion will be painful. Although also you will have weakness in the strength. So if you are doing it like this, this will be painful and it will be difficult for you to work with this wrist joint. Now what is Kienbock's disease? Kienbock's disease is a problem with the blood supply of the central bone. So in the wrist joint, there is a central bone which is called as a lunate. And if the blood supply to the lunate is hampered, you can have the problem which is called as a Kienbock's disease. Mostly it is an arterial blood supply, but occasionally there will be some venous problems as well. This problem is more common in males. It is common between 20 to 40 years of age. This is more commonly seen in the dominant hand. So if you are writing with your right hand, it is more commonly involved in the right hand. Very, very rarely you will have a bilateral mono. That means both of your wrists can be involved. Very rarely. This problem is not associated with any particular eating habits or other habits. Some people say that it is related to alcohol or related to steroids, but this association is not proven. So actually there is very less we can do to actually prevent this disease. And unfortunately, the same is with the treatment. So unfortunately, there are no medications available which can actually cure the disease or even prevent the progression of the disease. So unfortunately, if you are diagnosed of to have a Kienbock's disease, we have a very, very less conservative options. We will discuss what we can do, but most of the times it will be a surgical intervention or the surgical procedure that needs to be done. So if you are having a suspicion, if your doctor is having a suspicion that you may have a Kienbock's disease, you may be asked to get an x-ray done. And occasionally if the x-ray is normal or x-ray shows some kind of a doubtful picture, an MRI can be done. An MRI is the diagnostic procedure and is the most accurate investigation to find out if you are suffering from a Kienbock's disease. Now, as I told you, there is no predictors which can predict that you can have a Kienbock's disease, but there are some radiological parameters which suggest that you may have a more chance of developing a Kienbock's disease. One of those parameters, if you have a radius, so there are two bones. You have one bone ulna here and one bone radius here. Now, radius and ulna bones are usually at the same level. If the level of the radius is higher than the level of ulna, this is called as a ulna minus variant. Okay, and those kind of patients are having a higher risk of developing this Kienbock's disease because the loading will be more on the radius and more on the lunate bone. So this is one of the more common associations. There are some other associations. If you have a smaller lunate bone, if you have less inclination, you may have that. But the most strongest association is higher radius and lower ulna. So as I told you, only in those stages in which x-ray is normal and MRI may show some doubtful picture, there is a role of conservative treatment. And in those patients, we just give a small splint and immobilize your hand. So you are not allowed to do this motion. So only, and this is only also allowed for only 3 months of time. In rest, all of the patient, if you are suffering from Kienbock's disease, you are strongly recommended to go for a surgical intervention. Now there are several surgical interventions which are described, and I recommend that you take a call and consult your orthopedic surgeon about what procedures to be performed. I'll just brief up the procedure for you. There are some procedures in which we shorten the radius, so we reduce the load on the lunate. So radial shortening and plating is one procedure. Then there can be bone grafting procedure. This ground is a vascularized bone grafting procedure, which you can do in some cases. So in which we put the bone graft into the lunate whenever there is a loss. And there are some other procedures like denervation, like proximal row carpectomy, like arthrodesis. But that is out of the scope of this talk. But we have a separate talk loaded on the internet, on the YouTube. If you want to see what are the treatment options, you can go online and see that video. Usually, I recommend you to consult your orthopedic surgeon regarding the best surgical modality for you. If you have any more questions, you can write on the comment box, and I'll recommend you to subscribe to our channel for such similar videos. Thank you.